Welcome, my dear students. Let us learn the new chapter, cell, structure and functions. See, we the humans have so many organs in our body. We have hands, we have legs, eyes, ears, nose, lungs, heart, kidney, pancreas. There are so many organs are present in our body. So our body is made up of number of organs. Then what these organs contains? These organs contain number of tissues. Number of tissues together to form the organ. Then what is tissue? What it contains? Tissue contains number of cells. Number of cells together to form a tissue. So cell is the basic unit which present in all living organisms. Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So we can define the cell like this: the basic structural and functional unit of all living organism is called cell. So cells are present in all living organism. Some organisms having only one cell. Those are called unicellular organism. Uni means single. Cellular means cell. Unicellular means single cell. The organism which is having only one cell are called unicellular organisms. For example, you already learned about unicellular organisms in microorganism chapter. So in that chapter you heard about amoeba, paramecium, euglena, chromatomonas. These are the organisms which is having only one cell. So the example for unicellular organisms are euglena, paramecium, amoeba, chromatomonas. So these are the unicellular organisms having only one cell. So single cell perform many functions like digestion, excretion, respiration. Understood? So the organisms which is having only one cell are called unicellular organisms. Then what is called for the organism having many cells? Yes, the organisms which are having many cells are called multicellular organisms. The organism which having many cells are called multicellular organisms. Multi means many. Many cells are present in that organism. Example, we humans are multicellular. We have so many cells, like trillions of cells are present in our body. Cat, dog, bird, monkey, all these are multicellular organisms. So it contains many cells. So particular cells perform particular functions, specific functions. So some of the cells involved in some specific functions. So understood what is unicellular organism, what is multicellular organism. And you also understood what is cell. So cell, you understood it is a basic unit in our body. It is a basic unit in all living organisms. Then who discovered the cell? Who said that cell exists? Robert Hooke discovered the cell in the year 1665. Actually, he observed a thin slice of cork under a magnifying lens. What is this cork? It is made up of bark of the tree. It is made up of bark of the tree. It is used to close the bottle. So that cork he had taken and he sliced and he observed through a magnifying lens. And then he got to know that there are so many compartment like structures present in that slice. Number of box like structures are present in that slice. He observed through a magnifying lens. It resembles like honeycomb having so many compartments. So he coined that a single compartment or that single box as a cell. So that's why cell. Cell is the basic unit present in all living organisms. As I said, he actually observed in the dead part of the plant. So the dried, dead part of the plant. plant actually we have taken and he observed. So thus he got to know that the plant having the cell. See how a wall is made up of number of bricks. Number of bricks together to form a wall. In the same way, our body is made up of number of cells. So here one brick is considered as like a small unit. So in our body, cell is the smaller unit which is present in our body. So in the wall, brick is the small unit. In the same way, in our body or in any living organism, a small unit is called cell. So now we understood what is cell, what is unicellular organism, what is multicellular organism. So cells are of all having same size? No. Cells will be vary in size. Here the cell size, cell shape, number of cells are vary from one living organism to another living organism. There is not necessary that a big living organism having a big cell and small living organism having a small cell. So it is not like an elephant is very big having a big cell and a rat is having a small in size and it is having a small cell. It's not like that. A big organism may also have the small cell and rat also have the similar type of cells. So the cell size does not depend on the size of the organism. So the cell size will be bigger and or smaller. In our body, we have a small cell also, we have a big cell also. And you may observe that hen's egg, it is also a cell. It is also a single cell. You can see through direct naked eye. You cannot, you don't require any microscope to observe the hen's egg. The egg is visible to our eyes. It is big in size. So that is also a single cell. In the same way, we have so many cells which we cannot see through naked eye. We require microscope to observe the cells. So cells vary in size. It may be smaller, it may be bigger. So one organism will be having a bigger cells also and smaller cells also. So and come to the shape. Shape of the cells also vary. Shape of the cells does not depend on the shape of the organism. Shape of the cells is independent of the shape of the organism. And number of cells, as we have discussed, number of cells, many number of cells are present in multicellular organism, or only one cell are present in unicellular organism. So we understood the cell size, cell shape and cell numbers does not depend on the organism. So